Meet the Press with Paul Bongiorno.
Hello and welcome to Meet the Press. Politics has gotten grubbier, if that's possible, in the overheated atmosphere of the hung Parliament. The clean energy bills, code for the carbon tax, have finally made it to the chamber. But overhanging that debate is the fate of the Malaysian people swap deal.
Realise a clean energy future.
Order. The gallery will come to order.
A crowd of 60 familiar faces joined the opposition in a protest against a determined Prime Minister.
Today we move from words to deeds.
It is going to turn out to be the longest political suicide note in Australian history.
The refloating the Malaysian deal sunk by the High Court was the arm wrestle of the week. The government desperate for coalition support, the mood uglier than usual.
Leader of the opposition said to me, "Do you really expect me to accept an invitation couched in these terms? All I get is bile from you." If the Leader of the opposition has problems with statements made by me, well, poor petal.
If she wants us to support policy, she'd better get her policy to resemble what we think is in the national interest.
No, 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 and no.
The Greens will not be supporting the government's legislation, nor will we be supporting coalition amendments.
Greens leader Bob Brown is a guest. And later, former Liberal Immigration Minister Amanda Vanstone joins us. But first, Lachlan Kennedy has what's making news this Sunday, September 18.
Good morning, Paul. Here are the major stories we're following this morning. The Sun Herald reports the Prime Minister is facing a revolt from left members of caucus over changes to migration laws. MPs are reportedly concerned about what it means for Australia's international obligations to refugees. Yesterday, Immigration Minister Chris Bowen was confronted by protesters angry over the proposed amendment. The death toll from yesterday's plane crash at an air show in Reno, Nevada, has risen to 9. More than 50 others were injured. Federal officials are investigating the cause of the crash. Witnesses say the pilot, who was killed, saved more lives by swerving to avoid the grandstand. Libyan rebels trying to take Bani Walid, one of Colonel Gaddafi's last strongholds, are meeting fierce resistance. 6 rebels have been killed and more than 50 wounded. But the soldiers were able to enter the town of Harawa, 80 kilometres east of Gaddafi's home base of Sirte. And finally, the remaking of Julia Gillard. The Sunday Telegraph reports the Prime Minister has hired an image consultant to sharpen her delivery of major speeches. A spokesman has confirmed an outsider is occasionally brought in to offer a fresh eye and a different perspective. And Paul, those are the headlines this morning.
Thanks, Lachlan, and welcome back to the program. Bob Brown, good morning, Senator.
Good morning, Paul.
Well, all week you've been warning of an unholy alliance between Julia Gillard and Tony Abbott. It seems that that alliance is unravelling.
Well, it does, but politics is getting in the way of humanity and the rule of law here. The Greens are rock solid and have been for a decade on upholding international law and treating asylum seekers humanely, and bringing them to process on Australian soil as the international law and domestic law so far has required. But we're seeing that eroded by both the big parties in a cascade down to the bottom in policy. And I don't think Tony Abbott is the generous soul that he says he is. I remember 800 children at one time being locked behind razor wire under the Howard Abbott regime of a few years ago, to the point where they were mentally distressed and will be for life. We've got to do better than that. The Greens uphold, stand by the Refugee Convention signed by the Menzies government back in the 50s, and Australia should be doing the same, and the big parties ought to pull their socks up and abide by that law and do the right thing, which the majority of Australians want to see done. That the majority in repeated opinion polls are showing Australians back the Greens' position of having processing on Australian soil.
Well, as you've alluded to, Tony Abbott is sounding a little like a spokesman for Amnesty International. Here he is.
The problem with the legislation is that it strips out the human rights protections which the Howard government thought were necessary. If we say no to this legislation, it will be because we are saying yes to basic standards of human rights.
Well, is he saying yes to basic standards of human rights?
No, he's this is a sham. This leader of the opposition would be quite prepared to go back to the razor wire days. He's quite prepared to go back to the so-called offshore.
Well, he backs Nauru.
Pacific.
He backs Nauru.
Yeah, that's right.
And he says that the law that was under the Howard government still applies in Nauru. That, in other words, human rights existed there according to our obligations.
Well, people in Nauru were treated cruelly because they were left without knowing their circumstances for a long, long period of time. Inevitably, over 90% of asylum seekers who are treated by the Pacific Solution ended up here in Australia. They should have been processed.
So the bottom line here, is that your position, the Greens' position, is clear. If Tony Abbott votes down what Julia Gillard has put up, we're back to onshore processing, aren't we?
What happens if Tony Abbott votes down the Gillard position, and we will be, you end up by default with Tony Abbott supporting the Greens' position. Now, that's where this country should be. The majority of people want that. Wrong motive, right outcome.
Do you and Tony Abbott then accept that we could have up to 600 asylum seekers a month arriving by boat?
Well, that figure's been put forward, but that's there's 60,000 overstayers in this country who came by plane. And we don't hear Tony Abbott saying, turn the planes back, Paul. So, yes, that's a peak figure from last year. There's a far smaller number so far this year than there have been in past years. But Australia can absorb that. We're still dealing with a tiny percentage of the 200,000 people coming to Australia this year under various immigration provisions.
Senator Brown,
provisions.
Is there anything humane in allowing a people smuggler to put 100 people, men, women and children, on a leaky boat with only a 50% chance of them reaching Christmas Island, other than perhaps drowning,
well,
as we've seen happen?
The Greens, as part of our policy, do want to see much greater application of regional provisions. We want to see stronger laws in our neighbouring countries, much more provision for Australia to help out. I understand there's just two United Nations offices in Indonesia at the moment. You know, Australia can help out much better than it's doing in trying to ensure that people are properly processed in our neighbouring countries rather than left with this terribly dangerous option of getting onto boats in desperation to get to Australia.
Just briefly, one other issue. The Treasurer this afternoon, his economic note, will give the final draft, as I understand it, of the mining tax. I'm told that there'll be no more revenue here, that those reports are wrong, so it's pretty much as we saw it. What's the Greens' position on the mining tax?
Well, we should go back to the Treasury-recommended super profits tax, and the Greens are wanting the government to reconsider giving big corporations a 1% tax cut. We think that instead there should be a 5% tax cut for small business. That employs half the Australians in private enterprise. Keep the money here
and
in Australia.
And would you be moving amendments along that line?
Well, we'll be putting that to the tax summit, and we will move for that because we think small business, not the big banks and the big mining corporations, should be getting the break.
Time for a break. When we return with the panel, a media inquiry or a witch hunt. And Leader of the House Anthony Albanese can be a tease, but how's this for the taunt of the week?
And bad mistakes. I thank the Chief Government Whip for his important question, which comes 12 months to the day since the Gillard government ministry was sworn in. After our election victory last August. Which is why we're sitting on this side of the House and why they're still on that side of the House.